Hello all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In my last video, I had explained about the significance of the period statuses in GL module, and in my current video, I'll explain about the significance of the period status in accounts payable module. So these are the different statuses of a period in AP. So when I say period in AP, it's AP GL period. So the first status is never open, future interval, open, closed, and then permanently closed. Now let us see the significance of all these period statuses. So the first status of a AP GL period would be in never opened status. Unlike in GL, in AP, if the period is never an open status, you can still see those periods in the open closed accounting period screen. So let me show you that. So this is the AP responsibility. Navigate to setup. Sorry, it's accounting control payable periods. So here you can see I am still able to see the periods which are in never opened status. I can see the periods only up to June 2020 because in my calendar, I have defined the periods only up to June 2020. If I have defined the periods, say, up to, say, maybe 2030, then I should be able to see all those periods in this screen with the status of never opened. And the next status, okay, let me explain the other things. If the period is in never opened status, you cannot, and I mean, these are the three different kind of major transactions which you enter in AP. So you cannot enter or create any invoice under the particular period. You cannot make any payment. You can also cannot void payments in that particular period. And of course, as you cannot enter any of this transaction, you cannot even run create accounting and transfer to GL for those for the particular period. And the next status is about the future interval period. Again, this is an option. The future interval period depends on the number of future interval periods which you have specified in your financial options. So let me show you that. So in my current case, you can see that there is one future interval period, which is Jan 2020. And it is based on the number of future interval periods which I have specified under my financial options. Setup, options, financial options. So here you can see under future periods of the financial option, I have specified it as one, and hence the number of future interval periods in my open close period screen shows one. If I had entered the future interval periods as zero here, then I would not have seen any future interval periods. Coming back to this, like if the period is in future interval status, you can still create an invoice, but you cannot make any payments, or you cannot void any payments, and you cannot even do a create accounting of that particular invoice. And as far as going back to the previous status is concerned, if the period is in future interval period, you cannot go back to never opened period. In fact, in the drop down, you can see only one status, which is open. So let me show you that. Go to accounting period status. So as far as the never opened is concerned, you can see in the drop-down either future interval or open. So from never opened, even though you have specified the future interval as one, but from never opened, you can directly go to open status. If you want, see in this example, February 20 is in never open status. I can directly go to open, or I can go to future, and then you can change it back to open. So in this case, my Jan 2020 is in future interval period. If it's in future interval period, in the dropdown, it will show you only one status, which is open. It will not allow me to go back to the previous status, which is never open. And as I mentioned, if the period is in future interval status, I can still create an invoice. So let me show you that as well. Invoices, entry, invoices. Let me pick supplier site. This is the invoice date. So whatever I'm talking about, this is invoice GL periods. So invoice date can be any date. It can be past, or it can be current system date, or it can be future date. Test 500. It's already exist. Okay. Let's say test ARV1. Okay. So whatever I'm talking about is this GL date. Okay. So this is the today's date. So let me just change it back to, or change it to maybe January 1st, 2020, which is in future interval status. Okay. Let me complete the other field so that I can save this invoice. We just pick up any account, maybe just an expense account, and save this. Okay. System will allow you to save this invoice even though you have selected a GL period of 1st Jan 2020. Remember, this is what we are discussing. So system do not do any validation on the invoice date. Invoice date can be in the past, or it can be in future also. So if I enter an invoice date in the past, you just get a kind of a warning message, but it doesn't stop you from proceeding further. Say, take an example, let me change the invoice date from 2019 to say 2017. Save this. You get an error like warning message saying that this date is more than 1 year old. Verify that this is the date you want to enter. Okay. Okay, it will still allow you to save the entry. Let me change it to future period. Yes, change it from 2017 to say 2020, 14th December. Same. You get a message saying that you have entered an invoice date that is in future. Just say okay, and system will save the record. So system will still allow you to enter a past or future invoice date, but the validation, whatever I'm talking about, these things are only on the invoice GL date. So if I can just change it back to 2019. And then see, let me change it from 1st January 2020 to say 1st February 2020. 1st February 2020 is in never open status. So if I try to enter select a never open status, what will happen? You get a message, the date you entered is not in open accounting period. Open the period in control accounting period, which is control payables period, which is expected because 1st February 2020 is in never open status. Let me just close these things. Now going back to our Excel. Okay, the next status of the future interval is the open period. Okay. From future interval, you can change it to say open. Okay. And from open, you can change it to close status. So when you click here on the drop down of a period which is in open, you can see only one value, which is closed. You cannot go back to future interval or never open status. So, and again, if the period is in open status, then you can perform all kind of transactions. You can create an invoice, you can make a payment, you can void a payment, you can run a create accounting and transfer to GL. Again, you cannot go back to the previous status. And the next status is the close status. So when you click on the drop down, you should be able to see the status as closed. And if the period is in closed status, you cannot do an invoice entry, you cannot make a payment, you cannot void a payment in that particular period. And of course, as you cannot enter any transactions, you cannot do a create accounting or transfer to GL for any of those transactions which are in closed period. And of course, there is already a kind of a system validation that if there are any kind of a transaction which are not accounted and transferred to GL, system will not allow you to close the period. So ideally, you should not get into any kind of situation wherein there are invoices in a period, but you have already closed the period. Because if there are any such kind of an untransferred or unaccounted entries in any particular period, system will not allow you to close the period. You need to either sweep them to the next period. Ideally sweep them to the next period, otherwise system will not allow you to close that particular period. And as far as going back to the previous status is concerned, yes, if the period is in closed, you can go back to open status. See, if the period is in closed, you can click on open and you can go back to the open status. And the last status is about permanently closed. If the period is in permanently closed, you cannot again go back to the previous status. So if the period is in permanent closed, it's done and dusted. And obviously, if the period is in a permanently closed, you cannot do an invoice entry, you cannot make a payment, you cannot void a payment, and of course, you cannot enter any transaction, you cannot do any create accounting and transfer to GL for such kind of a transaction. In an ideal world, once your audit is done and once you expect that you do not expect a period to be reopened, you should actually permanently close the period. I mean, ideally, again, in my past 10 to 15 years, I've never seen any client who have actually changed the status from closed to permanently closed. They just keep the period in closed status, that's it. And then they will have some kind of other business controls wherein if somebody try to open the period which is already in closed status, they get some kind of an alerts and the notification goes to concerned stakeholders. Okay, so these are the different statuses of a period in accounts payable. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video, for interesting videos on Oracle Financials. Please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.